What's up, guys? This is Tony from Chi-Town Constrictors, and welcome back. In today's episode, we're going to cover my facility. I've had a lot of people ask me, what kind of cages do I use, how do I operate, what kind of heating, why do I like them, what are the pros and cons, stuff like that. So I'm going to cover all of that stuff with you today. Here next to me, I've got my adult female wall. This is where I keep all of my adult females and some of the females that I'm raising up that are going to get a little bit bigger than most of the males do. These cages are made by Freedom Breeder. There are other companies out there that make very similar style cages, and they all work just as well. I really like these because you can put some big females in them. These here are the 6-foot models. They're 6 foot wide, I believe 30 inches deep and 9 inches tall. That's a lot of space for a big boa if you've got some. They probably fit some other species as well. If you got retics, maybe some smaller size berms, something like that, these will fit some pretty good size snakes. Down on the end here, I've got a 4-foot model. That's great for the more average size boa constrictor. If I've got smaller females, I usually put them in there. Both sizes work well. One of the biggest things that I like about these cages is they slide in and out like dresser drawers. There's a lot of other caging options out there, a lot of them that are a lot more economical, you know, a better buy for your money, so to speak, because these are very expensive cages. But the reason why I go with these is because for me they're the easiest to get in and out of. Some of the other cages that are out there that are available have sliding glass doors where sometimes they flip up and down, and that's great and it works just fine. There's no problems with that. So if that's what you want to use, more power to you. They work fine. But what I found is that it's very difficult to reach all the way in the back and wipe down for cleaning, get bedding out, sometimes even get animals out. You know, if you have a little bit of a meaner animal that's trying to bite you, it can be difficult to do that when you can only come from the front. So the reason why I like these is because it slides in and out like a dresser drawer, and it's nice and easy. Being able to access these cages from the top makes everything a lot easier, whether it be from getting the boas out, all you have to do is reach in, pull them out, put them in another tub, or even cleaning. Just get yourself a nice little dustpan, scoop it out. I usually have a garbage can right here next to me. Just scoop, dump right over the top. Or even if you're ultrasounding, it's really nice to be able to just reach in and ultrasound the boa and not have to cause any stress by moving them around, taking them out of the tub, putting them into a different tub, anything like that. Same thing goes for feeding. It's very nice to be able to just be able to reach in, feed, close the drawer, and be nice and easy. Another thing that I like about these Freedom Breeder racks is the way that they use heating. They use a heat tape that sits along the bottom of each individual level, and you use it on a thermostat so you control the temperature of how hot you want it to get. And that way the boa can lay directly on top of the heat and they come in direct contact with it. There's other styles of caging and racks out there that'll put the heat along the back or sometimes along the sides, and all that does is heat a certain area of the tub or the cage. I don't like that idea. I like the idea that it will heat the bottom or the floor and the boa can lay directly on top of it and come in contact with it. That's especially helpful if you have gravid boas. You know, if you have a female that's incubating a bunch of babies, you should let her regulate herself and determine if she's too warm or too cold, and she will get on and off the heat as needed. So now we're on the other side of the room. These are my baby racks. These racks were made by a company called Matrix. They're no longer in business. They went out of business many years ago. You're not going to see too many of these available on the market anymore. If you do, they're used. They're great, actually. They're very heavy because they're made of, I think, half-inch melamine wood. So they're very heavy, but they do get the job done. They're just your typical shoebox-style tubs. They slide in and out. They also do have belly heat, which in my opinion is very important, especially for babies. When they're first born and as they're growing, they can have a lot of digestive issues. So the fact that they can sit directly on top of the heat, which is going to help them digest, is a big deal to me. So usually my babies, they start out in these small shoe boxes. They eventually grow a little bit and go into something a little bit bigger. These are 15 quart tubs. They'll spend a little bit of time in here, and then they eventually move down into something much bigger as they continue to grow out of each size tub. Once my boas grow out of a 15 quart rack, then they come over here and they go into a vision rack. These tubs are actually 32 quarts. It's a very large tub. It's more than double the size of the last ones. You can hold some pretty good sized boas in it. I've kept boas up to 2, 2.5 years in these tubs. It's a very effective rack. It's a good buy for the money. It's not going to cost you a lot. I believe you can get this rack and all the tubs for under $500 or $600. So cost effective wise, very good rack. What I don't like about this rack is the method of heating. It uses what's called a heat rope. That's different than the heat tape. The heat rope is exactly what it sounds like. It's a rope that you can buy, I believe, in either 30 or 60 feet lengths, and it weaves in and out of each level. The reason that I don't like it is it's very inconsistent heat. Even on a thermostat with a probe on it, this level will be warmer than this level. This level will be hot, then this level will be cold. It's inconsistent all the way through, and what I've noticed is it usually errors on the hot side, which is not a good thing. If I set my thermostat to 91 or 92 degrees, you take a temperature gun, you put it on the heat rope, you'll find that sometimes your heat rope will be running as hot as 105, 106. So, last but not least, we have my CB70 tubs. This is also made by Freedom Breeder. It has a 3-inch piece of heat tape that runs along the back. Again, the snake can lay directly on top of that. And each level has its own run by a thermostat. These are very large tubs. They're great for growing out females. They're great for adult males. I like to keep my adult males at a manageable size where they usually only eat about medium rats or so. I found that they're much more aggressive and energetic breeders that way. But again, these tubs are the perfect size for growing out females or adult males for pretty much the rest of their life. And as some of you guys have already seen in some of my other videos, I have a huge saltwater fish tank behind me. Saltwater fish have always been another passion of mine, so I decided to make a huge tank be the centerpiece of my snake room. Here we have my queen angel and my clown triggerfish. Those are two of my absolute favorites, and they were my must-haves. Over here hiding, we have what's called an annularis angel. He's kind of new to the tank, so he's still a little bit skittish and hides. And this is the one that's kind of become the mascot of the room. This is a Japanese dragon eel. You can see a mouth full of nasty teeth. He's very mean, and actually he's already eaten two of my fish out of the tank, so he likes sushi. And then I've also got over here what is called a Mappa puffer fish. I've only seen him puffed up all the way once, and it was actually really cool. It was about 4 times his normal size. I am planning to do a future video for you guys that are fish nuts just like I am. I'm going to show all the filtration and everything that went into it. Don't worry, it's coming. So that's it. That's my entire snake facility. It's small, but it's very effective. And as you can obviously tell, quality goes a long way when it comes to keeping and breeding boa constrictors. Everything in my room is actually going to be getting replaced here soon as far as cages go. Not that there's anything wrong with them. They all work great and I love all of them. But the same company has released some newer models with minor upgrades that I've really come to like. So I'm going to be looking to upgrade all of my cages very soon, but it's going to look very similar. I'll make sure that I show you guys that when I do. Right now, we're in the middle of breeding season. It's almost finished. I hope everyone out there is having a great season. My season's going well. My first litter is due to drop here in just a couple of days. I'm going to show you guys that as soon as they drop, I promise. I'm going to leave you guys with some pictures, show you what kind of stuff I've got coming. Best of luck to everyone this season. We'll talk soon.